Marriages continue in Pennsylvania, but the governor has filed suit to stop them. We'll have the latest from that state, plus civil actions in Tennessee, new data from Hawaii, and more bad news for the National Organization for Marriage. At the American Foundation for Equal Rights, I'm Matt Baum, and welcome to Marriage Newswatch for August 12, 2013. We hit a milestone last week. Pennsylvania's Montgomery County has issued its 100th marriage license to gay and lesbian couples. And there's no end in sight, with marriages likely to continue for at least another week. Pennsylvania Governor Tom Corbett has sued the County Register of Wills, but for now, it looks like they'll be able to continue issuing licenses while the case is considered. It's anyone's guess how this will land. The court could eventually invalidate all of those licenses, or we could get a major advance toward the legalization of marriage equality in yet another state. We're also seeing an advancing legal strategy to the south in Tennessee. Last week, two couples tried, and of course failed, to obtain legal recognition for their relationships. Now that they've been denied, the Tennessee Equality Project can move forward with legal action. Although they haven't announced a lawsuit yet, TEP is holding Marriage Equality Day rallies across the state on August 30th and 31st. Visit tnequalityproject.com for more info. It's been a bad couple of months for the National Organization for Marriage, and now they're under investigation for campaign finance issues yet again. This time it's in Iowa, where NOM failed to disclose donors to a campaign to unseat every judge on the state Supreme Court. For its part, NOM says that they don't have to disclose donors who gave via email and phone calls. But the executive director of the Iowa Ethics and Campaign Disclosure Board called that absolutely false. And we have another state poll to feel good about this week. A new Hawaii survey shows support holding steady in the mid-50s, with opposition dropping down to the low 30s. That's the lowest observed point yet for opposition, but the soonest we could see a marriage bill is 2014. We'll be keeping a close eye on all these states. Subscribe here on YouTube and at AFER.org for breaking alerts and ways that you can get involved. At the American Foundation for Equal Rights, I'm Matt Baum. We'll see you next week.